Let's talk about critics for a few moments.
Okay. Now,
just kidding, I'm not going to go there.
Oh, just go.
Well, most of them have a manuscript in the drawer they can't get published, so...
Oh. Oh.
You know, yeah. I don't read...
They are frustrated writers.
A lot of them, yeah. Yeah. I don't read many reviews. I learned a long time ago, life is much simpler if you ignore the critics. Because, I mean, they really have a lot of fun.
So what if Renee comes up to you and says, boy, this is a good one. They know you. They got you. You've got to read this.
I'll glance at it. Yeah.
Just glance at it.
Yeah.
And you seem to have read the New York Times.
I glanced at it. Somebody told me.
Oh, yes.
No, actually, it came out yesterday, which is the day before publication. I was not expecting it.
Right.
And there was, you know, a picture of myself, so I just read the review. And it was pretty good.
Well, it was pretty good.
Listen, Charlie, a few years ago, I was whining about something. I think it was a bad review. Many, many years ago, after a while, you get a pretty thick skin or you stop doing it. So, you know, I realized I'm thankful that at least we're reviewing my books. And my father, you know, one of these old guys who grew up in the Depression, said, stop whining, boy. I was 40 years old, but he told me to stop whining, you know.
I hate whiners.
See, I do too.
Hate.
And so, you know, I'm thankful they're reviewing the books. If it's an intelligent, thoughtful, smart review, I can learn from it.